Many are called, but few are chosen. Today, Blessed Pedro Calungsod will become the second Filipino saint after San Lorenzo Ruiz. But little is known about the beginnings of this young native who belonged to the Diocese of Cebu. There are neither records of his birth or baptism. For nearly two decades, attempts to identify his roots as a historical figure trace the name Lungsod or Calungsod to a number of major provinces in the Visayas.
Now everybody in the Visayas is claiming him, that he was born in Leyte, in Bohol, and so on.
Many accounts also bear witness to Calungsod as having studied in a Jesuit missionary for young recruits in Lobok, Bohol. Those written from June 1668 to 1672 spoke well of a young Filipino lay catechist around 14 years of age who assisted Jesuit missionaries including Superior Father Diego Luis San Vitores with evangelizing thousands of Chamorros to Christianity in the Ladrones Islands in the Western Pacific.
In the process of the research of the history of Guam, they rediscovered the process and the accounts of Diego de San Vitores. But in all these accounts, there was always a mention of a young boy or a young man, a youth from the Visayas, who died with him.
The mission, which faced religious persecution and enemies of the faith, was said to have also been the bloodiest. On April 2, 1672, as natives launched an attack on missionaries in the shores of Tomohon, Guam, at 17 years of age, Calungsod was said to have died a gruesome death in defense of his faith.
He became a witness, no? to the Christian faith, but not only that. He died for that conviction. She was a faithful to Padre Diego de San Vitores, who was the leader of the mission. And he was strong and agile, and according to the accounts, he could have killed. He died first. According to the accounts, he evaded many times. Spears were thrown towards them by the two killers, Matapang and Hirao. They were Christians, but they became apostate, and he evaded until he was struck on the chest.
He and his mentor were both slain and their bodies thrown into the sea. A year after their martyrdom, a process was initiated for San Vitores' beatification. It was forgotten and rediscovered in 1673, paving the way for Calungsod's own and later the cause for the young martyr's canonization. Caroline Howard, ABS-CBN News.